श्री कुमार केटकर जी।
ऑनरेबल चेयर सर, हाउ मेनी मिनट्स आई हैव, लेट मी नो फर्स्ट।
यू हैव 9 मिनट्स।
ओके, आई मे नॉट टेक यू दैट मच। वेल एक्चुअली वी मस्ट फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई दिस गवर्नमेंट चोज दिस टाइम टू ब्रिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर डायल्यूशन ऑफ द बिल। Obviously, the government is clearly afraid of the information. They thought that they are not afraid of the opposition because opposition doesn't have as many numbers. So they realized the real opposition will come to them from the correct information about the government's activities and government scams. So they realized that the real enemy is not going to be just opposition, but information in the hands of the opposition and in the streets. That power they themselves have seen. They were only 2 seats in 1984, and they used the streets and opposition within the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha to force the government to accept or reject many of the things. So this particular government is fully aware that the opposition can be strong with information and on the street protests. RTI bill itself came not because Lok Sabha demanded it or Rajya Sabha demanded it. RTI bill came primarily, as Sanjay Singh said, from the activists and the trade union movement and the farmers movement all over the country. And that movement, those activists actually forced the government to bring the RTI when UPA was not in full majority. But RTI came under the pressure of the people because they wanted information, because they thought the government is hiding many things, and unless information is procured, it will not be possible to fight the government. So people like Aruna Roy, Nikhil Day and many other activists actually participated in a mass movement on the street, and even Anna Hazare, whom BJP supported tooth and nail, also fought for this bill, and finally the bill came. So RTI is a product of a mass movement for democratizing the information and for democratizing the system. Therefore it is necessary that RTI must not be diluted. Now why government is particularly worried about information coming now at this point of time? After coming to power and about coming to power itself, there have been so many doubts. So many BJP, NDA and other members are surprised and shocked that they were elected. They don't know how they are elected, and therefore the voice was raised against various hera-feri, various scams that may have accompanied the election itself. Therefore the questions were raised about EVM, and that's how Election Commission came under the cloud. Now if all the right information was available or is made available to all the parties and all the people and in the opposition, how they won, how the NDA and BJP persons won in the election, a lot of information can be available and the government can be actually challenged on the basis of election itself. I remember one particular episode in which Mr. Kapil Sibal exposed that there are something like 3.5 lakh crore rupees counterfeit notes were in circulation during the time of election. He exposed that with a film. A couple of channels dared to show that film only for a minute or two, and then they immediately stopped. The media was being controlled, and that particular film, that particular evidence which Kapil Sibal produced, went only on social media. If all that information was to come and available with the opposition, this government will be really in danger, because not only that information, but the very election of this government could be endangered. I will just give you one small example. Mr. Jairam Ramesh talked about the Prime Minister's education, and which is in court, so I will not mention that. And I will mention something which obviously will not be appreciated by opposition, by ruling party, or by anybody for that matter, and that is because it is rather outside the fold. In Mumbai's famous Azad Maidan came and protested against the insecurity that she is facing, and that matter that she is feeling insecure did not appear in all the press, but some Gujarati press and some small English press published. Later on a question was put to Information Commissioner as to why herself feels so insecure and unsafe. And
I am told that you have one speaker.
Another insecure and unsafe.
Another speaker from your party. So you
insecure and unsafe. That question was rejected, that it will not be accepted because it is a question of national security. She had said that she is even denied the passport. So all those questions of gross injustice against, and that was not the issue raised by the opposition, by the Congress, or by any NGO. It was raised by...
Thank you.
I'll just take 1 minute. I'll just take exactly 1 minute. All such authoritarian governments are always afraid of information. I'll just give you one reference. The book All the President's Men and the film All the President's Men and the film The Post by Steven Spielberg, if any member chooses to see, they will realize what information can do to destabilize the authoritarian governments. When President of the US tried to bulldoze his rule, and when the information available with the press on Pentagon Papers and Watergate affairs forced him to resign under the clout of impeachment, I think all the establishmentarians and authoritarian people know that information is a very strong weapon. It does not necessarily require a large number of opposition members in Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. What it requires is a right to information, to use that information against any authoritarian or dictatorial rule, which is what RTI does. Thank you very much.
Thank you.